Since the dawn of humanity, man has dreamed about conquering the sky. And so have I since like middle school. However, my every attempt at making a flying earthy plane ended up in, well, a drastic crash. And it's not because the planes were badly made, it's more the fact that I am a terrible pilot. But today, it's all going to change, because in this video, I'm going to finally learn how to fly planes. And by saying learn, I mean install Ardupilot and make the plane fly by itself. So let's do it! Okay, so first, let's choose an airframe. For beginner-friendly plane, it should be durable and simple to build. So, conventional fixed-wing configuration with elevator, rudder and ailerons is out, because the more control surfaces we have to build, the more time we will lose if the plane crashes. So, the next contender, the delta wing, seems much more promising. It only has two control surfaces called elevons, which can control both pitch and roll at the same time. Delta wings also don't need a tail, which simplifies the construction a lot. But the problem with this configuration is that the swept back wing design can be tricky to build. So, to make it even simpler, we can take a look at flying plank configuration and just make the wing straight. This design is probably the simplest and most cost-effective way to build an RC plane. And to prove my point, here is a flying plank drone that Australians are currently sending to Ukraine in hundreds. They are meant to be expendable, so they also must be cheap and easy to make. And that's exactly what we are going to build. So, using my non-existent aeronautical engineer diploma, I created this design. First thing you may notice is that it has two propellers. And that's because I'm using the same parts from my recent tricopter build and I was worried one motor might not have enough thrust. Double motors configuration also has some additional benefits like differential thrust, but more about that later. Another thing that might bother you is that the wing looks a bit odd, like it's a really weird low poly version of the real airfoil. And you are right, this wing isn't normal, and that's because it uses something called Klein-Fogelmann airfoil. You see, standard airfoil profile requires the use of ribs, which can be difficult to build, but with KF airfoil, you can just stack foam blocks on top of each other like a real Minecraft player. The wing itself works by creating small vortices behind each step, which causes the overall airflow to look similar as on the traditional wing. People who fly it say it benefits greatly from increased stability and reduced stall, but studies have found that the wing does create additional drag. So, it's not really an efficient design, but for this simple and slow flying plane, it's a perfect choice! But before we start the assembly, we have to talk about today's sponsor, PCBWay. PCBWay is your go-to source for high-quality PCBs in all shapes and sizes. They can make any PCB you could ever want, starting from cheap two-layer boards and going all the way up to these unique flexible PCBs. They also offer 3D printing services, so if you want to make a project but lack the equipment, you know where to go. On top of that, PCBWay brings together a large community of makers, and this month they just started their 6th project design contest. So if you recently built something cool, why not share it with the world? You can submit your project as mechanical or electronic design, it doesn't cost anything, and you can win great prizes. So don't wait and go check out PCBWay website at pcbway.com. Back to the video. So, let's start the build by preparing the flight controller. In the last video, I flashed this Matek board with Ardupilot bootloader hex file. Thanks to this, from now on, we can make further software changes straight from the Mission Planner app. It's just a matter of getting the newest Arduplane file and flashing it through the install firmware tab. If installation went right, the flight controller should be displayed as fixed wing. Now that we have the right software, I think it's good time to actually build this plane. This specific airfoil profile I choose is KFM3, because it offers, quote, fantastic flight characteristics. And the main material I will be using is 5mm XPS foam sheets, which you can probably get in most DIY stores as floor underlay. So, now I'm going to shut up and let the build montage play, but if you want to follow and make this plane yourself, check out my printables and Thingiverse profiles for detailed build plans. Okay, as you saw, the assembly was pretty straightforward. And now when we have both servos and motors connected, we can begin the final configuration. Arduplane software is not that different from Arducopter, so I'm not going to talk about basic setup. For in-depth tutorial, check out my last tricopter video. There are, however, some changes that we need to discuss further. And first of them is the frame type section, or rather, lack thereof. In Arduplane, there are no predefined airframe profiles like hexa or quad in Arducopter. Instead, you need to define the aircraft design yourself in Servo Output tab. I actually really like this solution, as it allows for making some pretty creative planes with multiple motors and various control surfaces, like flaps, air brakes or differential spoilers. In our case, first we have to disable default functions, and then define both left and right elevon. Additionally, you should also manually trim each control surfaces to have 0° angle when in idle. You can also increase or decrease the elevon max tilt angle by changing those min and max values. It's also essential to define our plane's motors, and since we have two of them, we can set them up as right and left throttle. This way, the Ardupilot can control plane yaw by changing individual motor RPM. But for the pilot, it feels no different than having a plane with standard rudder. Now on the Arduplane side, we can read that for elevon planes, it's really important to configure mixing gain and offset parameters. I didn't really know which values would work best, so just to be safe, I only slightly bumped them up. Next thing that's very important for Arduplane navigation is functional GPS and compass. My BN880 module has nice GPS performance, but its compass is really crappy. To counter this, Ardupilot has a special function called GSF. It can calculate its own compass heading by comparing GPS and IMU data. And since it relies on constant movement, it works especially well on planes. And to set it up, we only need to change these two parameters. Up next, we have a wide selection of flight modes. For first-time flights, it's best to pick both fly-by-wire options. Now, these modes are really great, as they work in similar way to modern aircraft flight computers. It means the flight controller is doing all the heavy work of stabilization and steering, but it's still responsive to user input. And this makes it so much easier for new pilots, like me, to get a feel for flying without the immediate risk of losing control. For example, in fly-by-wire A, if you move the roll stick hard right, the plane won't roll over and crash, but will instead stay within the defined max roll limit. Fly-by-wire B works in similar way, but once activated, it will also try to keep the current altitude. You can even set additional safety measure in the form of alt limit parameter. By setting it to, let's say, 5 meters, the plane will pitch up by itself if you get too close to the ground. So in theory, this setting should prevent you from crashing, even if you tried to. I also recommend assigning additional switches on your radio to return to launch mode, which should be your failsafe as well. Takeoff mode, which can be used as loiter mid-flight, and auto mode, if you want to try waypoint flight and autonomous landing. Before we take the plane to the field, there are a few additional checks to be made. If you haven't already, you need to calibrate your accelerometer. But what I found recently is that for most planes, it's actually recommended to calibrate with the plane tilted 3° up for better flight performance. Next step is finding the center of gravity. I did it using an online calculator, but in reality it's probably not exactly there. It's not a huge problem though, as long as the plane is not tail heavy. So if you are not sure about your plane's balance point, at least make sure it's a bit nose heavy by moving the battery forward. Lastly, check 3 times that your control surfaces move in the right direction. Then go ask your grandma to check it with you. You need to be absolutely sure about this both in manual and fly-by-wire modes. Otherwise, your plane will instantly crash. But our plank seems to work fine, so I think it's time to finally let it fly.
Okay, so now, because our plane doesn't have GPS, it does have GPS, it doesn't have compass, we need to walk a bit to let it calibrate with the gyro. So I'm going to do it now.
What I meant here is that for the GSF to acquire initial heading information, it is advised to pick up the vehicle before arming and walk with it in a circle for a while.
Okay, and now we can test the stabilization. So if we pitch the plane up, both delevons go down, as they're supposed to do, and if we pitch it down, they go up, so it would be stable. And now to test the roll, if we roll to the right, this elevon goes up, so the total lift on this part of the wing is smaller than on this part, so it will stabilize. And the opposite happens if we roll to the left, so I think it should be okay.
I didn't want to launch the plane by hand, so my dad came up with an ingenious idea to build this portable runway. Our plank has plenty of thrust, so it should be able to take off even at such a steep angle.
Now we are going to start. I don't know what will happen. I'm a really bad pilot, but I got my fly-by-wire mode switched on, so it might work. Okay, so let's see. Throttle up.
And it took off! Just after the launch, you can see how the fly-by-wire system struggles to keep the plank level. But once it reaches a certain speed, the plane becomes very stable. The main problem I faced is that because of the roll limit, the plane turn radius was larger than I expected. And so I had to fly it over the trees, where it was hard to keep it in eyesight.
Okay, so it seems that it flies, but I have no idea how to land it. There might be a problem with this, but it actually seems to fly pretty stable. I'm quite surprised.
The flight experience itself was not bad, but at such a small field, I struggled to perform a good landing.
Yes! Alright, so the plane seems to be fine after the first landing. I'm surprised how well it flew.
Following this first success, I decided to fly again, but this time on a much larger field. Now this place is free of any trees, so I can fly without worrying about crashing into obstacles. This time flying the plane was a really pleasant experience, because of the Ardupilot making sure I won't roll over or fly into the ground. I could just relax and enjoy doing slow turns and flyovers. During this flight I also tested the RTL mode, and as you can see it makes the plane come back and circle the start point all by itself, even without a compass. Thanks to Arduplane, the aircraft was so easy to control that my dad, who held RC radio in his hands for the first time, was able to flawlessly fly it around. And because of the KFM3 airfoil, it also performs really well at slow speeds. Eventually, it started getting dark, and so I landed the plane for the last time. This whole flying day was really amazing, as I finally broke my plane crashing curse, and now I feel confident to build and fly more aircraft. But most important, our plank has proven itself as a great beginner platform. And if you also want to begin your adventure with RC planes, you can definitely start by building this design. Now guys, if you enjoyed this video, comment your thoughts about this plane, and if you want to help me make more projects, you can support me on Patreon, which I recently started. By subscribing, you will get behind the scenes content, early access to my designs, and you can even get your username featured in my videos. But for now, thank you all for watching and see you soon. Bye!